Unit 9. Androcles and the Lion. Let's find out what happens to Androcles who tries to escape from the slavery of his master. Androcles enters the stage, rushing and panting. He stops in the middle of the stage and bends forward, as if trying to catch his breath. He is carrying a jug of water. The lion is lying down at the edge of the stage, blending in with the background.
I think I'm deep enough in the woods now. No more of washing the master's smelly clothes for me. This rock looks almost comfortable. Ah, it's good to be free.
Behold, I am Dinah, goddess of the hunt, and goddess of all the wild beasts. This man cannot see me. Ah, one of my wild beasts. As you cannot understand its language, I will translate for you. This is what the lion said.
Do I smell a human in my midst?
Oh my God! You!
Human! You dare to enter my territory! I, the king of all beasts!
Oh my God! I'm doomed!
I would attack you, puny human! But the thing is, my front paw hurts. Ever since I ran through that thorny bush, am I still alive?
Human? Could you help me?
You're looking at me, like, almost like my master's kitten. The only creature that was ever nice to me in my master's house. Oh, your paw looks really sore.
It is. It hurts.
Dare I step closer? My, my. That's one big thorn you have in your paw. That looks nasty.
Big thorn. Nasty.
No. Wait a minute. You're not wanting me to take out that thorn, are you? If I take out that thorn, it could hurt more than ever. I'm not crazy.
Woe is me. I will always have this big awful thorn in my paw. Life is so unfair.
All right, all right. No need to get carried away. Maybe I can help you, after all. I can't believe I am actually considering doing this. I'm going to need you to calm down first. Do you think you can do that? Okay. Hold still. I'm going to pull it out now. Exactly. Why am I talking to this lion? Okay. 1, 2, 3. Here we go.
Androcles pulls back and wrestles to pull the thorn out of lion's paw. The lion moans as a tug of war over the thorn unfolds, then gives one particularly loud roar.
Ow! Well, you probably understood that.
When Androcles pulls out thorn, he falls a little backward, and so does the lion. The lion rubs his head on Androcles' hands like an adoring puppy. Thank you. It is out. All gone now.
Settle down. I still have to clean your wound. I'll just cover it with some leaves for now and tie them to stop the bleeding. I'll get some water from the creek to wash it clean. There, you might as well rest.
Androcles takes a leaf and wraps it around the paw of the lion.
Feels better already. My paw will be all right again. I can tell her.
The lion closes its eyes and lies down. Dinah tilts her head onto the back of her two hands, touching, then exits.
You got that right. Yes, that's good. Get some sleep. I'll be back in a few minutes with the water.
A Roman prison scene. A table is placed on one side. There are a set of prison bars in the middle. Androcles is behind the prison bars. The centurion soldier, Quintus, stands guard. The master stands in front of the prison bars angrily, with his hands on his hips. The lion's paw had healed now. That was the good news. Androcles lived in the forest for months with the lion. But here's the not-so-good news. One day, a troop of Roman centurions was passing through the woods. They discovered Androcles and knew they could get a fat reward for returning him to his master.
Ha! You thought you could run away from me? You ungrateful wretch! How did you find him anyway?
He was living in the forest. We were hunting this huge lion. We saw it drop a branch of berries at the mouth of a cave.
This man came out and ate the berries. After the lion left, we nabbed the man. Good work!
He tried to talk his way out of it.
But we know an escaped slave when we see one.
Your powers of perception are amazing.
Insolent slave! So, this is how you repaid my kindness. You ran away? And after I gave you food and a place to live for free. What are you talking about? I was your slave? What did you expect?
Not to be beaten to my bones and starved all day long. I'm a human being. I will never be returned to your service.
Androcles reaches out through the bars to attack the master. Cassius pulls the master back before Androcles can make contact.
Disgusting slave! How dare you try and touch me?
What is going on here?
Warden, I have had it with this slave, Androcles. He just attacked me. Of all the nerve! You know what? I will not take him back in service at my house. Keep him. Do your worst.
You mean?
You got it.
Uh-oh. No doubt, they are talking about the cruelest punishment of all. If you know anything about Roman history, you know what I am talking about. If you don't, well, you are about to find out.
This must be a smart one. Only a few are able to actually escape from their masters. Well, if you are so smart, you know what's in store for you.
No, not that. The lions? Have pity on me. Do not throw me to the lions.
Too late for that. Yes, this feisty slave will last longer than most. Take him to the Colosseum.
Quintus and Androcles out of the prison bar. Colosseum background. Crowd members are dressed in simple white togas. The lion is behind the cage door.
Gentlemen, welcome all to my glorious Colosseum, where the doomed meet their fate. What a show we have for you tonight! An escaped slave will face justice at the ferocious jaws of a hungry lion. How long will the poor fellow last? Bring out the slave!
Androcles is brought into the arena by Quintus, Decius, and Cassius. Androcles stands waiting at the rightmost part of the stage, shaking and afraid, holding only a small spear in his right hand.
As if luck would help him. Oh, Jupiter! Oh, Saturn! Please have mercy on me.
I heard this beast is the most ferocious one in the stable.
Have you seen it pacing in its cage? The moment that cage door is open, it will pounce. Quick, let's not miss it. Friends, Roman countryman, an escaped slave, will now find justice in the ring of the Colosseum. Are you ready? Let me hear you.
Crowd members are slightly enthusiastic. They cheer loudly.
All right, enough. Release the beast.
Quintus opens the cage door. Lion comes out and Diana follows from offstage. The lion stretches its legs and bounces inwards the direction of Androcles.
Dinner time.
That lion is huge. I'm dead. What can this teeny-weeny spear do to a lion? That's it. My last moment on earth. Okay. I give up. Just eat me already.
The lion charges up to Androcles, but stops when it gets close. Sniffs to the right and left. The lion stares at Androcles with a puzzled look on his face.
My friend, how have you been? I said, you can eat me now. Don't draw it out. Wait, it's you, my lion friend from the woods. The one with the thorn? Well, say, aren't we all healed up now? You want a kiss? How does that feel?
I missed you, human.
What's going on? What is happening? You, what have you done? You have bewitched the beast.
Androcles explained to the emperor how he had pulled the thorn out of the lion's paw in the forest and how he and the lion had taken care of each other while they lived together in the cave.
And that, your majesty, is what happened. This lion has treated me better than anyone I have ever known. By a long shot. Quite a story. Subjects, we have witnessed an extraordinary turn of events this day, because you, Androcles, among all others, managed to tame a wild beast. I grant you freedom. You are no longer a slave. You are free to go. I am free, your majesty. I am deeply grateful. But before I go, may I make one request, if you please? What is it, Androcles? To allow me to take the lion with me. Don't worry, he'll stay close to me. He won't bother anyone. Why not? It's a day for surprises. Free the lion.
So, Androcles and the lion went back to the forest. The lion always stayed by Androcles' side. Because of that, no one ever dared to bother him. Would you?
I didn't think so.
Androcles also had food every day, supplied by his loyal and trusted friend. And so, and I must say, it is not every day you hear this expression with reference to a lion. They all lived happily ever after.